Yeah, good afternoon, every one of you. We'll start the same problem, we will continue. So we have the coordinates here. So these are the points. Once we just drawn this n versus xy and at the same time distribution curve, we want these three points. Okay, these three points we already there. Now here the procedure is, okay, in the previous one, when we are just deriving the formula, graphical procedure and formulas. So I have said that first you will draw this one, then n versus y will be coming like this. This one is n versus x. Now what happens? The first step after drawing these curves is location of point F. Point F is F, YF and NF. Then after that, you have to locate a point R0, which is X0 and N0. Then you have to join these two points. Okay, join these two points. Then third point is you have to locate M1. M1 is at NM1 and YM1 according to the procedure. But here what happens if you see M1 coordinates of M1 is equal to F. Okay, the X axis of this F point is 0.1 and X axis of this M1 point is also 0.1. And Y axis of this F is also 0.125 and Y axis of this M1 is also 0.125. So M1 coordinates are equal to F. So because of this, so a small change in, a small change in the procedure, which we are generalized in the previous session. So now we will locate that points. So first point is R0. R0 is 0, 0. X0 is 0 and N0 is 0. That point will be this one. So this is R0 point. Then F point. Where is our F now? So F is 0.1 and 0.125. Okay. 0.1 and 0.125, I guess. F is 0.1, x axis is 0.1 and y axis is 0.125. X axis is 0.1, then this is 0.125. So 0.12 means it will be coming here. So this point is M1 point. M1, not M1, F point or M1, both are same. Okay, the, so this is same one. So what happens here?
Okay. Sir, you...
Chappan, chappan.
Wrong is not another, sir.
Wrong
point. Point wrong mark is not another, sir.
Ardhan Kala Ravi.
Points are
NF. A points?
M1, sir. F, M1? F and M1 point end, sir.
Ah, okay. Ida yes, F 0.1 x axis, y axis 0.125. Mm-hmm. M1 also same 0.1 and 0.125. Okay, Ravi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Dini curve inka show. So curve is not beyond this point. So we can just draw some connecting line here. Okay, a straight line you supposed to be draw until the last point of this graph. So this is M1 as well as F point also same one. So now F is equal to M1 here because the two coordinate systems are same here. In this case, you cannot draw the tie line, a cross tie line, which will have some angle. So in at this point, what you have to do is straight line is your tie line. So which is passing through this N versus Y to N versus X to N versus Y. So that is how the procedure, small change in the procedure. So for this type of values, for F is equal to M1 coordinate, we don't have an inclined line. We will have a straight line. So this right tie line. this is a straight tie line for this one. Then afterwards, you can after first stage, what is the outputs E1 and Y1 are the E1 and R1 are the outputs. So this point is R1 point, and the point at which it touches N versus Y curve is called as a E1 point. Okay, now what are the coordinates for R1 and E1 we have to estimate. So now according to the procedure, this point is E1, then this E point for the next stage, we have to connect this point to this point. So this is already F. So before we are we give this notation F M1, so we have to draw a straight line with interconnecting F and R0. So this one is the first stage. We can call that as a dummy stage, we can say. Okay, this one is stage one, which is a dummy stage. We are not at all giving any solvent to that one. So it is not at all satisfying a leaching condition. So in order to leach that one, we have to give something, but it is a settling tank or simply a dummy leaching section, we can say. So this is one. Then this we have connected. Then we have drawn a tie line. So this is a tie line. After drawing this tie line, what we have to do? So we have to connect this E1 and R0. So E1 and R0 we have to connect. So now we have our points M2. So M2 we have to estimate. That M2 will be falling on this point only. So how to estimate M2? Okay, until this is it okay?
Yes, sir.
M1 point you got. After that, you have to draw a straight tie line or a vertical line. Why? Because F is equal to M1. Both coordinate systems are same. That is because we are drawing a straight line. Otherwise, if these two values are not equal, then we will obtain the tie line as an inclined tie line. So there is no inclination in this case. For the next stages, inclination will come because that's a true leaching stages. This is not a true leaching stage, only this is a dummy stage. Okay, just they are allowing to settle that one. Then, now M2, we already know. Yes, M2.
You have to calculate M2, sir.
Yeah. Before that, for stage one, already we have to calculate. Okay, this is stage one, which is a dummy stage. We have drawn in a square box. So F we know, this R0 1 we know. Then we have to estimate this R1 and E1. So before estimating that, the points we have to note that. We already know that B is equal to some NF into F. Why? Because NF is B by A plus C and F is A plus C. So cancel out. So B will come. This is also equal to this one. So output, one of the output, E1 and N1. Because E1 is A plus C and N1 is B by A plus C. So A plus C will be cancelled and only left is B. So this B1. Now from this equation, we can write that E1 is equal to B by some this one, E1, N1. So B we already know that. So this is 125 by what is N1 here. So from the graph only we have to obtain what is N1. So the point at which this is E1. So corresponding value on the y-axis will be your 0.465. N1.
0.465.
Yeah, 465 or 467 or 47 also you can write. 465 is it getting in that one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think 47 I obtained because it is. Okay, 47 I am taking. So this one is how much?
0.266.
0.266. Then for this first stage, the material balance, we know that one. Two inputs are there. So F plus R naught 1 is equal to E1 plus R1. So from this one, we can calculate our unknown parameters. Since this is zero, we are not giving in any input for this stage. So F is equal to E1 plus R1. So F, we already know what is F. F is 1 kg, which we have taken a basis. Then E1 already we estimated, that is 0.266 plus R1. So implies R1 is equal to 1 minus 0.266. I think 0.734. Yeah, 0.734. Okay, R1 is equal to 0.734. R1, we already know R1 is nothing but solution. The weight of solution in the raffinate phase or a this phase, okay, overflow phase, R1. Then we got this point. From graph, what we get? This one. From graph, we obtain N1 is equal to 0.7 and correspondingly, we have to obtain Y also. So this one is X as well as Y, the both coordinates are same here. So R is also X, and then the corresponding value on E1 is Y. So this is both axis X and Y. So Y1 is also 1 because it's a straight line. Because it's a straight tie line, there is no deviation in the values. Because of this, this is X1 is also 1 and Y1 is also 1. Then after that, we have to conduct a stage 2. So stage 2, how do we estimate the stage 2? Okay. Now at stage 2, what happens? They already given that the R1, which is obtained in stage 1, is equal to R0 2. So same amount of water they are feeding to that one. So R1, we have got 0.734 kg. So 0.734 kg of water they are giving to the second stage. So with, so that is a pure water, so X0 will be 0 because X0 is the measure of C, C by A plus C. So this is 0, X0. Then R02 we already obtained, then water is obtained, X0 is 0. Then the material balance for the stage 2. So stage 2, the material balance. So the stay from the stage 1, E1 is coming. Whatever the E1 is coming, that is going into this one. And from the stage 1, whatever the value R1 is coming, that is going to here. This is R1 is equal to 0.734. Then here it will obtain E2 and R2. So similarly for the mole fractions, it is X2 and this is Y2 and E1, Y1. So we already have this Y1 also here. E1 value also, we already have this one in the previous 0.266 E1 value also. So the unknown parameters are this one E2 and R2 we don't know. Now we have to conduct a material balance for this stage. So input, two inputs are there. When you conduct a material balance, E1 plus R02 is equal to two outputs, E2 plus R2. So R02 we already know, E1 also we already know, E2 and R2 we don't know. Now we have to equate this equation with some midpoint, which is M2. Similarly for the solute balance, solute means for C balance. So this is E1 into Y1 plus R01 into here it will come X0. So R0 2 into X0 2 or X0 because it is 0 in every case is equal to, this is equal to M2. M2 into YM2. From this one we can write what is YM2 is equal to E1 into Y1 plus R naught 2 into X naught 2 divided by M2. So here X naught 2 is 0 from this one, X naught 2 or X2. So X naught 2 is 0. Then we can write this as E1 into Y1 divided by M2. We can write the known parameters, which is E1 plus R naught 2. So from this way, we can obtain
YM2.
YM2.
0.0266.
So first, say me what are the values of this one, so that it will be easy for everybody. This is, I think, 0.266, right?
Yes, sir.
Into Y1 is 0.1. 0.1, okay. 0.1 divided by E1 is 0.266 plus 0.734. 0.0266. Yeah, okay. This will be one. Yeah, okay. Yeah. So this is YM2. Then we have to calculate NM2. So by definition, we know what is NM2. So NM2 is equal to B by M2. Yes. So B we already know that will be constant 0.125 divided by what is M2?
One.
Two we can calculate.
One.
Somewhere we calculated that step M2.
In the above step only M2, no, sir. E1 plus R naught 2.
Yeah, yeah, that's once again I want to calculate here because somebody will find difficult. So E1 is 0.266 point plus point R2 is R naught 2 is 734. Okay, this will equal to 1 kg. So this is 1. So NM2 is also 125. Now the new coordinate system, which is point M2, we have to draw. Yet what coordinates? NM2 comma YM2. So these coordinates are NM2 is 0.125 comma YM2 is 0.0266. So these points we have to keep in graph. M2 we have to locate. M2 is NM2 is 0.125. Ravi, what is value of NM2? This one M2 0.125 only, no?
M2 also.
M2.
M2.
NM2. NM2. NM2.
NM2.
Coordinates. Coordinates. 0.125. 0.125. And this one is YM2 is 0.026.
But exactly 027 is coming on the slide.
No problem. Third coordinate we cannot take, third value, third digits we cannot take in this graph. Yes. Two digits we can use. Anyway, it is 0.02. Okay.
We are then taking x axis equal to 0.0.02 only, no sir. So it will come as first coordinate.
Okay,
only.
Yeah, yeah. 0.026 means it will be this one. And 0.125
is exactly coinciding with 0.125 on this line, even or not line.
It has to be coordinated with this line only, but I think
if I take this in the even calculation 0.465, we will get E is equal to that B by B by M2 is equal to 0.27, sir.
0.27. Okay, yes. 0.27 also the same, but maybe the connecting lines I am not connected exactly. So because of this, this point is coming somewhat above. Okay, but procedure you have to just observe this one. Any point you can take up to the 15% or 30%, they will give. No problem in this type of graphs. This is procedure oriented graph, so that we can take. No problem this one. Procedure is very important. So this is point is M2.
Yes, sir.
M2 point with coordinates NM2 and YM2. So after that, we obtain this one. Now we have to draw the tie line. So how to draw this tie line? So once again, you have to assume the points. So assume some point, then from that point you can draw this graph. So how to assume that point? Anybody can say what is the guess value?
0.02524 will be better, sir.
25 or 24? Okay.
I took 0.2. It is for
0.024,
huh? Yes, sir. 0.024.
0.024. Oh, okay. It is falling from this point. Okay. 0.026. Okay. 0.024. Okay. This point I am taking. So now the procedure is you have to draw this one. You have to project this line up to the equilibrium curve or a distribution curve. So this point will be same as 0.024. Okay, this point will touch until here, I think. This one. Okay, you have to project. I am not projecting here. You have to project like this. Okay, that value.
Zero to four is also not coming, sir. 25 will be better.
Okay, 25, yeah?
You take 26, sir, otherwise. I am doing 25.
26 means, okay, okay. Previous value is 266, no? Okay, we can take that.
Sir, for 25, I got exact value, sir.
25, okay.
From the middle.
From my graph, I have to check. Okay, I'm checking from my graph. Okay, point. Yes, 25. Okay, for 25, you will get this point. So 25, you can assume as your x value, x guess value, or x2 value. From this, you have to project this line. So this will coming very nearer to here. So here only it will coming. Then once again, you have to just project up to the diagonal. Then this value needs to be projected once again up to the top like this, n versus y axis. So you have to project somewhere like this. Okay, after projecting, you have to connect these two lines with a straight line. Then if that straight line, within the straight line, if your M2 value is falling, then it is correct line. If that doesn't fall, then that is your wrong guess. Okay, for 0.25, you can assume your line is falling. So this one is, then after projecting in the bottom graph, distribution graph, in the distribution graph, if you see, if you project this point 0.25, so according to this 0.25, it will come 0.03 or something. Then this is same as the previous value, which is 0.25. So this is x2 and this is y2. Now compositions, already we found out the compositions from this values. Okay, from these values we can find n2 value. So it will come like this. So, okay, above the curve it will come 0.61 or 0.62, we can take. So this is 0.62 here, 0.62. Now this point is your e2 point and this point is your r2 point. Now this is stage 2. This is one stage. This is second stage. Because of dummy stage, it is coming like that. Okay, okay. This is one, this is two. Okay. So now we found out our N2 value and Y2 value, X2 value. Okay, then N2 value is equal to 0.62 or something you will get. Then X2 value is equal to 0.25 and y2 value is equal to y2 value is equal to 0.3. How much you got, Ravi? 0.3? 0.034. Now all the values are there. The unknown parameters we can calculate based on this one. Now all the values are there, the unknown parameters we can calculate. Now from this one, so the previous one is this one, NM2 we already calculate, then E2, okay. The missing parameter is this one, E2 is equal to B by N2, yeah, B by N2. So B we already know that one, so 0.125. divided by N2 is this one, 0.62. So this something will come.
0.215.
21? 21, okay.
0.612, sir. I got 0.204.
Okay, oh, only we will accept only one value. Okay, your values you tell. 0.612. 612. Okay, then this is?
0.204.
Okay, since this is E2, so this will be in kg. Kg solution, so A plus C. Then R2 we can find out from the material balance equation. That material balance equation is E1, which is coming from the stage 1, plus R02 is equal to E2 plus R2. Implies E1 is, now just we calculated, 0.204. plus R02 is 0.734, I guess. Is it right? 0.734, that is?
Which one, sir?
R02. So R1 you can tell. 734, I guess.
Yes, sir. 0.734.
Okay, 734 is equal to.
E1 is 0.2.
Yes, yes. E1 is
0.266.
Oh, 266, yes. This is previous value and this value is E2. So, 0.204 plus R2. So, this will be 1 only. So, R2 is equal to 1 minus 0.204. R2 is?
0.79.
79, that's it. 5, 7.
Yes, sir.
Okay, 6 we will take. No problem. So, okay, this is also solution. Kg. Solution Kg A plus C. Then we already obtained this point. Then next stage calculation, next stage, third stage.
Maybe that is the final stage, no, sir.
No, no, no. One stage is there, no? One is dummy stage.
Yes, sir.
Then next one is the two washing stages they told.
Two times water.
Second stage means first time water, this is.
First time water is this E2, sir. Now we will get the value of E3.
This one, see the diagram. So F is entering by F. So R1. So this R1 value, the same quantity is replaced with one water. So one more is there, na? E3 by 3, R3 x3.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Next stage we have to find. This is last. Yeah,
that
yes.
That is
what I'm saying. Yes, yes. Okay, then stage 3. So stage 3 is this one. So input for stage 3 is E2, Y2. Then same they are replacing, same quantity of R2 they are replacing with the same quantity of water, which is R2. R2 is equal to how much? 0.796. Okay, this one only with the same quantity. This is solution kg, but this is solvent, same quantity of solvent they are replacing. So this is R2 is equal to R02 is equal to that one. Then the output which is coming is R3. then this is E3 and Y3. This is R3, X3, then this is X0 is 0 since this is a pure water. So this one is coming. Then using the material balance, once again I am conducting the material balance. E2 for the overall solution, E2 plus R03 is equal to E3 plus R3. This is overall for solution. Similarly, this is equal to some midpoint, which is M3. Then for the solute balance means for only C, E2 minus Y2 plus R03 into X03. Or this one, X03 or X0 we can say, because it is 0 already. So E3 into Y3 plus R3 into X3 is equal to M3 into YM3. Then from these equations, we can find out what is YM3. YM3 is equal to E2 Y2 plus R03 X03 divided by M3. So from this equation, M3 we already know from the first equations.
M3 1, sir.
Oh, once again it is 1. Okay. So this one is YM3 is equal to, this is already X03 is 0. Then E2 into Y2 by M3 is, from this equation we can take this one, E2 plus R03. So this is equal to E2. E2 is how much, Ravi? E2 is 0.204 into Y2. Y2 how much we got in the previous case? 0.1, no?
0.025, no, sir.
25, yeah. Okay. Then E2 is 0.204 plus R03 is R2 equal to 796. So this one, how much you got?
5.1 into 10 power minus 3.
5.1 into 10 power minus 3. Okay. 10 power minus 3.
3 zeros and then 5.1. 0.30.
Then NM3. So NM3 is equal to, once again, B by M3. So B is already constant, 0.125, divided by M3 is 1 only, I think. M3 is equal to 1. So 0.125. So NM3 is, once again, 0.135. So Y2 into V2, 0.20.
Sir, Y2 0.034, no, sir.
0.034,
huh? 34, yes, sir.
Y2 V2. Somewhere missed value. Yes, Y2 is this one, 0.034.
Oh, sir. Yes, sir.
0.034, okay, this value will change. How much this is? YM3 is equal to
6.936 into 10 power minus 3.
Yeah, 6.936. Into 10 power minus 3. Right. Okay, it is Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now okay. It is net problem, I guess. 0.798, so 0.204 plus 0.796. My OneNote screen is visible, Ravi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. 6.936 into 10 power minus 3. So this is YM3. Now we have to put a point M3. M3 is NM3 comma YM3. So NM3 is this one 0.125 and YM3 is this one 6.936 into 10 power minus 3. So that point we have to locate on our graph. Yeah. Before that, you have to just connect these two points, E2 and R0, according to the procedure. So, E2. E2 and R0, yeah, connected. Now we have to put M3 point that will lie on this point only. So that is NM3. How much is NM3?
0.0069, sir. Almost
0.006. 006, okay. Okay, no problem. And this one is YM3.
Sir, you got the wrong value, sir.
Which one?
0. You first consider 0.125, sir. You will get it on the line. You consider N, sir, N value, NM2 value.
There, I calculated wrong.
Consider it.
Consider it.
Consider NM2 first, sir, then you will get it on the line.
Okay, NM2 is how much?
0.125.
Yes. NM2, okay. 0.12, okay, yes. This one is YM2, YM3.
0.07. 007.
Okay, it will get here only, no? 007 means this one only. There only you will get because of connectivity problem. In the physical graph, it will come as such. If you want, I will share my graph also, physical one. No problem. Okay, here it will come. So this will be called as point M3 point. Now from this M3 point, once again, the same procedure, which is you have to draw a tie line. So for tie line, anybody can tell me the value of guess value. So my guess value is 0.006, it is coming.
Yes, sir, 0.006.
Yeah, if you assume 0.006, it will be coming. So here, this is point. So now you have to project that up to the equilibrium curve or a distribution curve. So this point, you have to project like this. In a straight line, you have to project. So you will get like this. Then up to here, up to the diagonal line, you have to project. That line you have to carry upward. then you have to connect the two nodal points. Then you will obtain your E3 value. This is E3 and this is R3. So this R3 value. Now this point you can project this way and you can estimate the N3 value. N3 value is equal to 0.66, I think. 0.66 it will come. Then this value in the bottom when you project that one. Okay, same value when it is projected on the equilibrium curve. So the corresponding value here will be Y3 value and here the corresponding value will be X3 value. X3 is equal to 0.006 and Y3 is equal to 0.0012. 0.012, huh?
Yes, sir.
No, okay, no, not 12. 16 something it is. See, this is why 5 is crossing it is. So 15 or 16 you will get.
No, sir, because you take this 0.0066, sir, N value.
N value, this one, N3, X3.
From the table, if you take 0.066, the value is 0.01015, almost.
0.066, okay. X value is 0.0066.
From there, I got only 2.2 blocks away, 0.012.
Now, what is your point there?
0.012, sir.
How can you get 0.012? This is curve. This curve is right. So yes, this sir. Curve for that curve, it is getting at this point. It is hitting at this point. Then the corresponding point you have to take on the y-axis. So corresponding yes, point 0.01, and this is already crossing the half of the box above is there, that one.
No, sir. More than half is crossing half.
Once again, I will see the point. Okay, yes, in physical graph it is coming like this. I don't know in this why it is not coming. For me also same one, Y3. Y3 you have to draw physically, don't believe in this graph, online one. So physically is 0.012. Okay, sir, now already, yes.
I am showing the value, sir.
You are showing? That one, okay. Yes.
Almost yes, 0.01.
Yeah, 0.0, yes. Okay, Ravi, yeah. Then we already got these points. So N3 is 0.66. So N3 from graph. N3 is equal to 0.66. Then from graph, X3 is equal to how much will be this one? Y3 is equal to
0.0. N3 X3 is equal to 0.006.
6 Y3 is
0.012.
Yes, 0.012. Now we got this point. Now we can calculate the unknown parameters. E3 is equal to, we already know the formula, B by N3. Okay, B by N3. So B already is, we know, 0.0125 from the starting onwards, same. So N3 we got from graph. This is 0.66. So this one value will get something in kg.
0.19 kg.
Yeah. 19 kg, this means this is solution A plus C. Then the material balance, from the material balance is this one, E3 E2 plus
R0 or not two.
Two or not three. Okay, or not three. This is third stage. This is E2 plus or not three is equal to E3 plus R3 is equal to M3. So from this one, the known parameters are M3. We already know M3 is one. M3 is one, Ravi.
M3 is equal to 1.
So from this one, we can say R3 is equal to M3 minus E3. M3 is already 1 minus E3 we just estimated, which is 0.19. So you will get 0.81 kg solution. A plus C. Now the recovery we have to calculate. So that much amount of E3 amount of solute is left in the sludge, or with along with CaCO3, it has been left. So E3 meaning, what is E3? E3 is coming here. So this is underflow phase. This is overflow. So in the overflow, R3 will be there. Here E3 will be there. Whatever the composition which is left in E3 is 0.19 kg of solution. A plus C left. A plus C will be left there. Now the percentage recovery we have to calculate. So how much amount of C is present in the extract phase? So how we can calculate? E3 into Y3. So what we will get? E3 means A plus C. Then Y3 means C by A plus C. So A plus C will be cancelled. Only C will be there. So this is a valid equation.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then using this one, E3 into Y3 is equal to how much? E3 is 0.19 into Y3 is how much?
0.012.
Yeah, 0.012. This is
2.28 into 10 power minus 3.
2.28 into 10 power minus 3. Kg
2.28 grams means
2.28
grams directly.
Yeah, 2.28 grams. Okay, okay. Yes. Then now we have to calculate percentage NaOH or C in sludge along with CaCO, NaCO3 or CaCO3 solid. So CaCO3 is equal to E3 into Y3. So this is outlet or in along with sludge. And along with input, percentage means with respect to input we have to calculate. That is Y into YF. This is already equal to 2.28 into 10 power minus 3 divided by F is 1 kg we already taken. Then in the NaOH is 0.1 already. So into 100. So we will get something. So 10 something 2.28 percentage of original. Okay, what is original? Original means it is a feed. With respect to feed, 2.28 percentage of NaOH has been left in the extract phase. So this is problem. If anybody is having any doubt, just raise the doubts. This problem is somewhat clumsy, so you have to do on your own, then only you will understand. So regardless of how much I teach in this online, so you are not going to understand anything unless you go and draw the graph. This one physically you have to draw, this one, then only you will understand. Okay, any doubts from anybody?
No, sir.
If something doubt is there, I will feel happy. No doubts means I'll suspect something. Ravi, you are okay. At least you've drawn, but other members, yes, I don't know. In the last batch also, they have done the same thing. They never carry the graph paper into the classroom. Since this is also online, I don't think nobody will carry this one graph paper. Okay, Pavani.
Yes, sir. I have drawn, sir, in the graph paper.
You have doubt, huh?
No, sir, I have drawn, sir, along with you.
Okay, you drawn. Okay, okay. Yes. Okay, Vamsadhara?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Is it okay? Everything?
Yeah, okay, sir. Okay, understood.
Okay. Anybody? I don't remember the many names from your class. So, Ananya? Is there? Yeah, she's there.
I'm also drawing the graph, sir. No doubts, sir.
No doubts, okay. And roll number two.
Sir, no doubt, sir.
No doubt, but graph you're drawing or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Roll number three. Anusha, hold on, hold. Okay. Roll number five.
Yes, sir.
Graph, are you drawing any difficulties there?
I did not draw on graph, so okay.
Okay, then have you understood this one problem?
A bit confusing, sir.
Where exact point, if you tell me, then I will explain.
Sir, I will refer and I will ask.
Okay, do your part, then if any doubts are there, just come to me. Okay, no problem. Yeah, okay, quickly I will just summarize this one. Then we will go in the next class, the next one. This is multi-stage counter current operation, which is very, very important. So the procedure already in the morning itself I summarized. Okay, I will just introduce this one, continuous counter current operation, so that in the next class we will start the derivation part. Yeah, this is continuous counter current operation. In this one operation, if you compare from the previous one, only the one stream, which is the extract stream, is going to affect the next stream. But here what happens, the simultaneously all the two output streams is going to affect the next stage. So this is all interdependent stage. So if you see the feed which is coming to the stage one, and the solvent is entering on the last stage. So this is initiation of the solvent and this is initial feed. Then the outputs which are coming from this first stage is going to the next stage, and which is the solvent which is coming to the last stage, which is going to the next stage, which is n minus 1th stage, we can say. So that is the notation scheme here. So since this is a first stage, so feed is entering here with YF composition and NF solid composition. Then the output is same notation scheme, nothing different, only NP. The previous stage, of this NP is nothing but NP plus 1th stage. And after this NP, something NP minus 1th stage will be there. So this is for indication, there may be many number of stages. This is for indication only. There may be many number of stages will be there in between. So in order to, we will not go into much stages. Only we will concentrate on the first stage and NP stage, then we will generalize the equation. Then once we generalize that equation, in place of NP, whatever the stage number is there, you can put that stage number there and you can easily calculate, you can easily have the formula for that plate if you generalize up to the NP plates. So these are the equations which will come. So we will discuss this one. So it is very, very important because the graph is also very, very difficult in this problem. So until now you have seen the single stage graph and this multi-stage cross current graph. So these two, compared to this one, these two are very, very easy. Now the problem comes here is this point, a difference point, this delta R. So this difference point, how to locate this difference point will play a major role. How at what corner of your graph paper you have to locate your x and y axis so that you can accurately locate this delta R, because in the examination nobody will provide you extra graph. You cannot connect the graph with each other. So in the single graph only you have to draw. So that x and y axis and these the length of this x and y axis you have to fix so that your delta R point will be falling in the only single graph. So that's a critical point. If you can locate this delta R point accurately, your problem will be solved. So this is somewhat critical. So before going for the next class, you just revise once again the previous two classes, because when you understand the single stage operation, this one, you are going to understand this multi-stage cross-current operation, if you understand how to calculate the stages from this cross-current operation, then it is interlinked here in the counter-current operation. So if you understand those both cases only, you will understand this case. So this is very important. Many times they are giving as a theory also. Okay, discuss about the multi-stage counter-current operation or how to estimate, write the procedure about how to estimate number of plates in the continuous counter-current operation, or one problem they are giving. So in one unit, there will be a two questions. So one question will be a theory they are giving, and other question they are, theory means this derivation and the graphical procedure. Then in the next one, they are giving the problem they are giving. So you better needs to concentrate on both. So problems somewhat critical. I will recommend that nobody can understand that one. So how to solve, nobody can initiate that problem. So because of that disadvantage, better you can learn the theory as well as graphical procedure. Then that is very easy. So okay, if you have any doubt, you can just ping me on any time. Okay, thank you.